away from CLG and going with LeBlanc and Kasdan.
So with the amount of switches, do you think these teams are actually going to be focusing comfort picks onto the players that are still there that haven't been switched up and then get Kevin and get Kerp what they want since they're melding with the team?
Well, first things first, the banning strategy for red side oftentimes was to leave as many top laners up as possible. Yep. Since the top lane kind of pool of accepted OP champions was Mundo, Shyvana, and Rengar. Rengar's not available this tournament, but it's Mundo and Shyvana. Right. And since neither of those were banned, and if Nien plays the standard fare, this means that CLG, since they picked red side, gets one of the two top laners as well as another power pick. So if they're playing the game here, they get the Elise and the Thresh's, unless RNA is willing to play jungle Shyvana, then it's fine. But I'm actually expecting him to pick jungle Shyvana.
We didn't see this at all to make mention that those three passed through bans in EU. This is the first time we really saw this.
Yeah, so very different pick and ban phase.
And fast.
A little faster than usual. The Jinx is something that CLG played a lot of the last time they're in Germany at IEM Cologne. The Olaf, though, is actually going to be a little bit new for them, and that could actually be what Nien plays in the top lane.
He is, anybody who is really an Olaf player is having fun with that again, and it's awesome to see players when they get back on champions that they like to play. It's always that little extra, that the extra oomph they give it. We may see the Gragas coming out as well, but the compositions just be completely, it's like they already knew what they wanted. They didn't care what the other team was picking, and they almost said that in the video.
This has got to be the fastest champ select we've had in quite some time. Let's see, CLG now gets to kind of counterpick their mid laner. If they're the old CLG, it's going to be Orianna for Link. But have they changed things up a little bit? Is he playing more Assassin-style champions? I'm not sure.
Well, he was the Roam Link. We always know him for leaving the lane, getting a little bit of help from whoever was in the jungle at the time. And it is going to be his pickup.
Afremu's got to be the one to lock it in, but Link's got to tell him what he wants to play first.
So much damage already to come out in the forefront of this composition.
Ooh.
Are we going to see Nidalee being used? Has been used over in OGN quite a bit for a lot of kite sustained compositions. When you just don't want the fight, but you want to make it hurt.
This immediately becomes more of a poke comp for CLG because all of their laners and their jungler can throw very dangerous poke from range when they're trying to siege a turret. That's going to be CLG's MO when they go in for this game. I look over at Alternate, though, and they're much more about trying to find sustained fights and chasing people down. Everything from Leona to initiate to having the double kind of top lane tank synergy from the top lane and the jungle with Mundo and Shyvana.
Well, that's what you want against the poke comp. You want a way to find a quick and easy direction to the back line. They have that at least on the Gragas barrel and the Shyvana ultimate, or Leona ultimate, I should say.
It's going to be rather interesting, though, to see if Mundo and Shyvana, for so Kevin and RNA, can stay in the fight, because so much of CLG will be to repeatedly run away. They have a lot of disengage on that side. I actually favor CLG's poke composition here if they can execute it right.
We'll have to see. Remember, the Battle of the Atlantic continues tomorrow with the North America's XDG, the team formerly known as Vulcan, taking on the resurgent Gambit Gaming.
Yeah, and that action actually kicks off Saturday at 11 a.m. Pacific. Yep. Same starting time as today and 8 p.m. Central European time.
Get more of these Battle of the Atlantic points on our favor. We just play them all today.
I have to see. Well, that'll be a long day, Riv. Personally, I got up pretty early.
So, talking about CLG's comp again. Well, yeah, I think we all did. These guys did, too.
Yeah.
Big props to the crowd for coming out.
Absolutely.
And they're pretty loud as well. Mm-hmm. It's cool. When they were first coming on camera, it's always enjoyable because they're like, oh, yeah, we're in the studio. That's us this time. Like, let's wave. It's really cool to see, and I'm glad everybody's having a great time because we are about to get this Battle of the Atlantic match started. And it is going to be CLG versus Alternate. As we head on to the Rift, it is going to be, as Jat said, Alternate on the blue side. CLG coming in with what may look like that long extended game comp. They're staying away from the fights, and they're going to do it their way as usual.
Yeah, but first things first, we can't get to the late game yet. We got the laning phase. And this will be...
Do we have to?
Do we have to? We have to. Right. That's what Double Lift actually tailors most of his AD carrying support picks about. So many teams nowadays do the 1v2 almost exclusively. But CLG actually likes to force 2v2s as much as possible because Doublelift and Afremu really love laning against two other people, and they don't necessarily play the tower dive game as much as other teams.
Looks like we are going to get the regular matchups in the lanes.
He's changing guns.
He's absolutely changing guns, making sure his cue works. You have to. Talking to the players a lot, when we were on the analyst desk sometimes in EU and somebody would try to flash the bottom brush wall, I'd say, you know what, Pagé, I can't flash that wall. And he's like, we actually joined the game and put on summoner cooldowns and whatnot and flash that at least three times before starting. So the little things these guys do to get themselves ready to actually get into the game, which is the reason they usually don't flash face first into the wall.
Usually not in the first few minutes either, unless it's St. Vicious at Blue Buff.
Confirmed on stream.
Yeah. So right now, this is an incredibly defensive level one. Maybe we could have expected CLG to get a little bit aggressive because Aphromoo does control Thresh, but they're just not willing to go into that type of danger. And this is an extremely cute strategy right here by Alternate. They're trying to get a surprise kill onto CLG. You can see Kevin has brought Teleport on Mundo, so they're hoping that Doublelift and Aphromoo get a little bit too close to the sun and they can kill them with three people.
Jay Ree
on Leona. I'm guessing he hasn't skilled up anything yet. He's going to go for his stun on Leona, probably his Q, and maybe lock someone down. This is going to be tense. They're not coming from the direction that Alternate wants them to, but maybe they can still pull them off.
Are they going to get antsy and stay in the bush? I feel like this is 25 levels ago when you're just starting to play the game, and it's a good idea to stack the bottom brush.
Is Aphromoo going to look at it?
Oh, it's first Kevin coming out. Aphromoo's going to be the first hit. They flash, they stun. Aphromoo's down to 250 HP. First blood going over to Creighton.
And he played him the wrong way as well. If Aphro could have flashed immediately as he saw the Mundo, it may have saved his life. But because Leona got that Q stun off, the bush trick worked. Welcome to America there.
Battle of the Atlantic, and they get the ambush attack to start it off here, coming out of the bottom brush. Moving up to the top lane. Kevin gets the assist on that, so it's actually just going to give him 3 minutes of vision. He really buys a ward and some potions for himself, so he's got a bit of safety. But we've seen the Mundo Shiv, the Mundo Tanky Bruiser top lane. We'll come back to him later.
And one thing we have to keep in mind now that we are on the 3.14 patch, that first blood, since it was so early on in the game, is worth less gold. So typically a first blood would be 400 gold for someone, but since it was pretty much at 2 minutes, he only got about 260 gold for that, so 40% less. Not as bad as it would have been in days past for CLG.
See how they decide to continue and play this bottom lane. Looks like they're gonna keep it pressed up to the turret. No, they don't want to take it just yet. That mid lane is going to see Kerp and both Link trying to go back and forth. Whether they fight each other or not is their forte, but I believe the roam's going to be happening towards that six as Dexter.
That was great timing.
Making his way down. Creighton coming in. Oh my god, Jayree walks in front of the hook, puts himself up in the fire. Can he get himself out? Jayree looking to get out of this when it's to level twos to one or two level threes. And that extra ability, not what they needed. They got the auto attack.
So a lot of things worked right for CLG there. There was actually a ward in the river for Alternate that died as Dexter walked through it. But it was a smart lane to gank because they knew Jayree had already flashed in order to get the first kill. And since this kill was at 4 minutes, CLG actually got full gold out of that one and evened it out.
There we go, 4 minutes in. Both teams now know that if blood is taken, it needs to be drawn back, and CLG acts on that immediately. Nobody's really gone back to do too much in the spending area. Creighton just picking up that ruby crystal. And they're even in gold in that lane as well. Nobody really grabbing the lead. The support only gained off of that.
No, we're just trying to see some counter jungling from Aranea. Shyvana has nowhere near the early game pressure that Elise does. For the most part, Aranea is just going to try and deny his jungle right here to almost punish Dexter for ganking, as long as Aranea can escape alive, as he's just recalling inside CLG's jungle.
They definitely know the positioning now of Dexter. He has to be careful. Oh, he knows those just got taken. He's not communicating it with the team, but that's Dexter, as you saw in the video. Filtering in the information, he knows where he has to go now. He makes sure that area is actually clear first and may just go ahead and stick top lane to not waste time.
Yeah, well, they also know Kevin has no combat summoners up there because he's brought the teleport, and this is yet another gank coming in from Dexter. He might actually expect Shyvana to be near since he saw Shyvana clear out the double golems were gone. It's like, well, maybe he's trying to gank after that and he's looking for a counter gank. But as we saw in the video, Dexter's the one who likes to gank first. This is more of a counter gank for him.
He knows he had that little bit of time to play with. He is hanging out quite a bit though, Kevin. Very patient, not even wanting to try and trade. He knows what the result will be, and it's just a back and forth. Dexter's just that much closer. Oh, very nicely played. He actually placed it really within the minion, so it wasn't even a problem.
Yeah, he smelled something was up. There is a reason Yen was so close to a giant minion wave, and it's because he was trying to initiate a trade. That's why Kevin decided to ward the brush and get away safely.
Almost telling the lane, reading it like a book by the minions. Still looks like Dexter will stay out. He knows he missed too much, so he's going to keep farming his own jungle. Arnea has only gained 10 CS off of this, but he is missing that assist that Dexter was able to find on that gank in the bottom lane.
More counter jungling coming out from Arnea as well. Since he saw Elite, he's going to now counter jungle his wolves a little bit. He's not pulling himself too far ahead, actually, though, since Dexter's level 5, Arnea is level 5. He's going to have to die a little more heavily if he wants to really shut him down.
Yeah, you gotta suggest or think. At what point are you kind of just farming over that guy's going to be getting ganks and, you know, really hurting the lanes? Arnea though making presence in the bottom lane. Dexter's been in that top lane for at least 2 to 3 minutes as Arnea has been trying to get himself bolstered up here. Looks like he will be able to back. Sword boot starts for Dexter, and the Doran's blade start actually on Arnea here, or after the machete.
Yeah, it's a little surprising that he hasn't upgraded quite yet, but he's looking for that early game dueling most likely on Shyvana. And I do want to talk about Double Lift and his lane with Aphromoo a little bit right now.
Yeah.
Since he has actually brought the cleanse on Jinx, yes, that's to get out of Leona's stun a little bit, but it's also because he's only looking for late game hyper carry right now. That's the reason he picks Jinx and Illusion, because he wants to survive in the lane. How did he get that? For a second, I thought Link was going to mess up his blue buff, but he got it. No worries. And Double Lift and Aphro, I feel like, are almost fully passive in this lane unless they get a gank.
They got the 75% mark of that lane pressed up just past the river, and Dexter looks like he's going to start hovering. The Roam is coming out from Kerp, so that means they have freedom on the bottom side, but are they going to be able to react correctly? Diving Leona is not the easiest thing to do.
No, that would be a very... dangerous and coolish gank.
A lot of endless alleys. Hello. Here they're walking into.
Well, they found RNA's counter jungling. He's going to try and smite that away before Yen can collapse, but RNA's in a lot of trouble.
He doesn't get that. Oh, coming down. Getting that reckless swing in, and he's going to be chased over by Link here. Oh, very nice cast, blowing him back. He is going to take the extra damage, but will they just decide to go in here? Kerp is forced to turn tail on this one, and he's going to be chased down. The pursuit is coming in by Kevin. Link finds himself in a bad spot. Barrier and flash to get out of that. He'll be safe, and Nien, still with Ragnarok, is ready to run around.
Arnea thought he knew he was going to level up off that red buff, and that's what allowed him to escape through. Still has his flash.
Ooh. Knowing there's a lot of commotion in the top lane, a great grab on Kreatine. Aphromoo can't follow up as the flay was just used, but they are getting good trades in the bottom lane on both sides.
CLG didn't want to fight down there because Alternate had the level advantage. That was a level 6 Lucian that they hooked in, and fighting with that would have probably been Fnatic.
Yeah, absolutely. And we are back into the matchup. Look at that. They are actually doing Dragon.
They were doing it this whole time.
Boom. So they're going to pick that up. So a huge commotion towards the top lane. We saw Arnea getting low. Actually, Flash and Barrier was burned by Link in that engagement up top. So quite interesting that they chose to head their way down to the Dragon and do something so scary right away.
At least they got it.
Yeah, they did get it.
Yeah.
They got it. And then they're going to check that they got it.
Yeah, this will be a very quick thing. Arnea has just had a lock camera that he needs to be able to unlock, is what I have just heard.
Some people play locked camera.
Dyrus used to.
Yeah, no, just...
Oftentimes you play locked camera before you are talented enough to move the camera yourself. I'd say it's a big disadvantage to have a locked camera.
Yeah, actually. People come right up behind you and you have no idea. It's kind of hard to play the game when you can't see everything.
Yeah. Double Lift had that problem. He needed glasses.
Go figure. Now he wears them all the time.
He doesn't have them on right now.
No.
Hopefully he got contacts. Otherwise, he's in trouble.
It's actually the same with Zuna. He doesn't like to wear his glasses either.
Well, that's because he goes so close to the screen.
Yeah. Well, he does without them.
Yeah. What?
I guess he plays better without them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That doesn't make sense.
I know. That's why I brought it up. We'll get it.
Thanks, Rev.
So we're seeing if these guys are set. They're kind of milling about slowly to make sure that the game is set for them. You can see the awesome crowd still hanging, enjoying themselves thoroughly here in Los Angeles, California, as the Battle of the Atlantic is underway once again. So we're just coming up on the 10-minute mark. The gold has not had too much of a deficit to be seen yet in the favor of, or I guess, at alternate. So CLG just holding on to that mostly with the Dragon.
The Dragon is pretty big for CLG, but obviously not as big as it would have been in Season 3. Early on in the game, the Dragon is worth slightly less gold, whereas by the end of the game, it's worth 260 gold a person. That's when the average level in the game is 15 or above. So this first one, while nice for CLG, doesn't give him a big lead.
RNA getting spotted out in the bottom. He's got a red buff to be working with, and he's only staying 10 CS above on Dexter here. I'd be interested to see how Link builds if he goes for pure and all damage, because Dexter quickly going for those Sork boots to get himself around and really get himself back in.
Yeah, I'm feeling like Link and Kerp will both just be itemizing the Athene's Unholy Grail as of now, since they're kind of just poking at each other, and it's mostly a farm off in that lane. Except Kerp will be able to push back Link a little bit more heavily.
Still real no big action that's going to sway this game yet. We see everybody playing safe, looking for the weaknesses, but it's really not what they want. They're keeping the vision up. All the yellow trinkets is really not slowing the game down, but making everybody play a lot more cautious.
Yeah, there's no sweeper in this game yet.
Right.
And it's interesting because I've been watching a lot of Aphromoo's games, and he doesn't like to build a Sight Stone, at least at any point early on in the game. He loves to rush the full upgrade on his Ancient Coin, go all the way to Talisman of Ascension, before getting a Sight Stone. Aphromoo's completely content just using his Warding Trinket and a couple purchase wards to keep his bottom lane safe.
It looks like Link and Kurt may just want to hang out for a while. They've both upgraded already that totem to the greater totem, have a longer ward in their lane, so they're just keeping themselves happy farming.
Absolutely. You can see no sweepers in this game, which seems like a bit of a CLG strategy. They're not trying to clear off. Ooh. There's the ult. Let's see if they get on Aphra.
Zenith Blade going in. There's the Dragon's this. Oh, there's the HP, and no, it's not. Double it looks to be the second one. The Cullet comes out. It's just the end. Oh, Creighton finds two more in the matchup to put himself at three.
Great finish right there, and now three kills onto Creighton. We knew he was fifth place in Europe in kills despite only playing in three quarters of the games. Well, he's 100% of the kills on his team right now.
Man, Barrier probably would have saved Double Lift there.
Absolutely it would have saved him. Also, if he would have cleansed the instant he got slowed by Jayri's ultimate, he could have gotten alive.
That is
but
true.
That was kind of being greedy with summoner spells.
Ooh.
And one thing that did happen in that gank down bottom, well, maybe fight up top.
Oh, yeah. I think Kevin's like, I can do the big damage, and then Nian gets his swing back, and they're kind of trading even here.
Nian says, I can do damage too. But talking about that gank that happened in the bottom lane, one of the big reasons it was more successful is Aphromoo tried to flay Jayri out of his Zenith Blade, the E that Leona gets closer to him with, but he flayed too early, and he actually got fully closed on and stunned, which helped the follow-up to finish off doubling.
Dexter just hovering in from the side. The Cocoon could hit from there. A very nice body slam out, but already Arnea there reading that one, and he would have been ready for the re-engage. They have everything up, and that would have been a pretty big fight for them.
Yeah, the last time we were super surprised about how Link got the blue buff, he had a trap on him. The trap actually DPS'd it out.
Good
little,
eyes.
A little bit of lucky. I didn't see it. Someone told me.
So the gold lead actually swinging over these kills. This CS, that explosive cast. And they're going to hang on for a second.
Here comes
another one. The Zenith Blade on the Aphromoo. Oh, there's a traffic jam in the rush hour right now. Doublelift getting pushed off of this one. And Jayri and Creighton are just going to take care of the lane.
This lane's really bad right now for CLG. There are no tank stats on Aphromoo. And any time Jayri wants to even land a slow from his ultimate onto Aphromoo, it's going to kill him. And that Leona ultimate, it's not like it has a long cooldown. 60 seconds from now, that can happen again to Aphromoo.
Looks like Nien trying to hold off what he can with a quick Spirit Visage. Looks like Kevin's doing some good damage. He's going to equal that out and sum it up with a Sunfire Cape. Bringing it back a few years. Nice air or spear coming out from the hands of Link. So his roam now begins, and we see that Kerp is actually going to hug middle here and actually get most of his fights from people coming to him.
Yeah, CLG's trying to babysit the bottom lane a little bit, but that's going to pull resources from the rest of the map and end up hurting CLG even more so. If Link goes down bottom again, Kerp is just going to take his turf.
See, Kevin does have his teleport up, so he can also participate in a fight that needs to happen bottom lane. Leona ultimate looking like it's going to be about 20 to 25 seconds. I'm sure Doublelift and Aframu are trying to keep those timers in their head because it really means their lane right now.
They have to turtle entirely right now, but it's just a bad situation for CLG's bottom lane because the minion wave is pushed beyond the halfway point. They can't farm. He's trying to steal that little guy.
And quickly shielding off his red buff.
Got to guess where it is.
It's like I hit something. I'm going to try again. I can hear it. So I think Aranea actually saw a few of those spears as well. You could see Kurt hovering down to make sure the entire path was safe, but now they want to go straight back at him. They want to say, give me that blue buff. Good damage on the Link. Ghost on the barrier. Here's Dragon's Descent a bit too far off. They flash in with the Ignite. Ooh. It's going to be the last barrel. Dexter trying to get their flashes over the wall, but only to stop the turret damage.
Really just some fantastic placement there by Kerp, and the dragon has respawned, so this is just even more good stuff for Ultimate.
Getting everything they need right in a row here, and it looks like this is going to put them up another chunk of 1,000. They will have 23 to that 20k coming up, and attention, Alternate putting themselves on the board a lot right now. 20 CS in that mid lane, 20 CS in the bottom lane.
Every lane is actually doing quite well, including the top lane where Kevin is stealing Dexter's jungle because he has had to help so many other places on the map. This is Alternate really looking strong with their new, I gotta call it their new lineup as well, since
absolutely
Kevin is new to the team and Kerp is playing in a new position.
Rocking that trackball.
Oh yeah.
So one turret has only fallen here in 16 minutes. We've had actually quite a bit of personal action, but the objective action has been quite slow. Dragons back and forth during the previous brief stop we had earlier. But right now, Alternate has found their way and got everything situated because they are right back in the face of CLG.
And so much advantage can be taken very shortly here in the mid-game for Alternate. You can see Kreaton has his Trinity Force completed, meaning he can now kill turrets at a much faster pace. That's one of Lucian's biggest strengths when he rushes the Trinity Force, because not only does he get the Trinity Force proc on turrets, he gets to do his double shot and really take them down fast. You can see the item advantage, even though it's small, exists for Kerp. He's got that extra blasting wand and Doran's Ring over top of Link. And of course, Aframu and Doublelift can't even look at Jayree because they're going to get hit by a solar flare and then jumped on.
So they got regular wards getting placed down in the bottom lane here by Jayree. We got that sweeper out for himself now, so they may be trying to get some teleport stuff going on in the bottom lane. We'll have to see. It's really just been Jayree on the solar flare. These guys are doing it in a two-man team without anybody else.
Well, he's got the sight stone now, so that's why he has the sweeper. But since the mid turret is down, there's just all kinds of action. You can see CLG's trying to plot a dive onto Doublelift and Aframu.
So much control.
This is also doing is just denying Doublelift's ability to farm. Even though Doublelift is on a late game carry and Jinx, that won't matter if he's not allowed access to creeps.
He can't, he's impatiently walking in between those two turrets in the bottom lane, and that should be the safest point for him right now. Aranea still knows that they can pressure into this. That mid turret falling right now is being used perfectly by Alternate.
Dexter's trying his damnedest to stay away from this one, but he has nowhere else to go. If he can't get his wolves and his team can't defend him, they can't do anything.
They can't even, yeah. The lanes can't be called for help right now. They're just causing so much chaos, and they can even get a Mundo if they wanted to. They'd lose a turret, so right now they are in perfect position to keep doing what they're doing. But we've seen what happens if you don't do anything for 40 minutes. It doesn't look good.
No, CLG has no lane presence or jungle presence at the moment. As much as Dexter is trying to escape and have that full magic pen build, he wasn't able to do anything. Now they're trying to go pretty much the only place on the map that's left to them. They've lost control of their upper jungle, so they're gonna try a dive on a very far Mundo with his ultimate. Let's see what happens.
All right, there's only one thing that can stop him from teleporting out of this one. It looks like he throws down the ultimate, and the crowd control is gonna be a bit broken up for him. He should be able to get out. Oh, he gets down with the undertow. Very great way to capitalize on the burst damage from those champions.
Yeah, Link landed the bullseye right there onto Kevin, and that's the reason they were able to secure that kill. That's the only place CLG could have went to make something happen.
And this is great. Alternate should have been pushing this mid turret. Instead, they were drawn up top, and now they're chasing the kills. They're chasing something that happened instead of CLG.
And they actually got a lot of poke on a Jayree, so maybe a turn for CLG.
He's trying to walk right across that culling, and he just takes it to the face. Doublelift still going in. Great job by Creighton just putting up a personal sentry wall. May find himself going down as Ephraim, who could go in hard here, throws down the lantern.
Oh,
the season blade goes over. Is there enough burst from the passive? One goes down. Will he be able to turn this one around? Link is a huge factor in this fight, but Kevin's going to put himself in the front here, and I think they are going to be able to thwart off anything else. Link in a bad spot. Ephraim is going to, I think, I can him into the situation, and they are both going to end up going down.
That went from bad to worse. Kevin teleported in, and everything went wrong.
Oh, dear. There goes the ghost. Olaf trying to make his way out of here. Ragnarok is coming up in just a few seconds. If he can get it to come off, will he try to use it? Will he go down? It comes up. He doesn't use it. Well chosen. He left it.
There was nowhere for him to go there. Ragnarok would have just been a wasted cooldown right there for Seojin Yen. And things just kind of got out of hand there. You can see the Doublelift tried to go in, but as soon as the lantern came in, Jayri landed the stun onto Doublelift, which killed their damage. And then even though Link and Kevin arrived at the same time to that fight, it just wasn't enough. You can see there's no way once Link gets toe-to-toe with Amundo, can he do anything.
Oh, so many times when you want to help somebody and you had no way to get out.
Yeah,
you just go down and make the best of the worst. 9-3 now as the kills just keep going in favor of Alternate. It's not CLG finding one and running with it. It's Alternate finding a few and continuing on. 34,000 now to 27,000 gold. Only 20 minutes into this matchup. Inventories are filling up quite fast, and those core items more completed in the inventories of Alternate than CLG.
Oh, absolutely. That's what happens when you're up about 7,000 gold. It actually seems like Creation's going for an Infinity Edge on Lucian. What's really interesting about this whole back and forth matchup with Creighton and Jayri is there's not even a Vamp Scepter on Creighton. That's how little threat or harassment Doublelift and Aphromu were putting out on him, that he could just rush his Trinity Force and now go for an IE. He doesn't even care about Lifesteal because there's no harassment getting landed on
him. See where these harassment can be put out by some of these Talismans of Ascension if they can get into these fights. That's what Alternate's been trying to do. We said they chased the last fight. They chased it up to the top, but they are ready back for the dragon as it comes up. This will be the second one in their favor. They may lose this top turret, and Nian's swinging at it, but he doesn't have too much damage just yet. He's not sitting on the cut list, but he looks like he's trying to build a bit more defense before that.
Yeah, oftentimes Olaf wants the Blade of the Moon King to chase him down. But many things, Riv, have gone wrong for CLG here, or gone completely right for Alternate. They've managed to completely shut down COD's bottom lane, and that's mostly from a 2v2 perspective. Yes, Kevin did have the level 1 gank that burned out from his flash, but then COD got a return kill, so it should have been neutralized, and it pretty much was.
Really, what it came down to was great jungling by Aranea, continuously the counter jungle, because our matchup is Kerp versus Link, but it's really been Kerp and Aranea in the jungle of Link. He can't get his buffs. He can't even help Dexter when he's having trouble.
That's a big thing. I really do think Aranea's gank in the bottom lane, just to give Alternate the confidence to go in with Leona and Lucian,
right,
as soon as they landed that first Solar Flare and just obliterated COG, it was kind of like, oh yeah, we can do this by ourselves now. And then they continued to get the kills on the rest of COG. Four deaths for Aphromu's Thresh support. You can rush the Talisman of Ascension all day, but it doesn't give him any health.
Right.
He's missing out on 180 health from Sightstone. And I can see in some situations how the Talisman of Ascension rush is a good thing, but not when you're getting hard engaged on, and not when you're brawling through and through and losing your brawls. You need some defensive stats in there in order for it to work.
Yeah, at this point, you're just being canceled out by the other Talisman. You try to use yours, the other one's used, nobody has it. See, the Infinity Edge. Huge damage. Nobody wants to stand in front of Creighton now. We said he is one that had some of the most kills in the EU LCS and only played in 75% of the games. The Solar Flare comes out, and even with partial vision in the fight, they try it. Kerp gets locked up, and it is a death sentence. But whoa, what? Aphromu goes down, and Kerp lives. The Drunk Man almost gets out with his resistance is, and it is going to be a re-engage. Dexter goes down, but it's great kiting and fighting. Creighton just firing backwards.
Hey, a 2-for-2 is a great result for CLG when their jungle is getting invaded just like that. Yes, Dexter and Aphromu may have overcommitted a little bit, but it was kills and potential for the carries. Let's see exactly. We're wondering how Aphromu died so fast. It's because there's a whole burst of damage from Alternate can fly out. As soon as they got Kerb, it meant everybody in. Aphromu flew in, right into the culling and some barrels. That's why he got blown up so quickly. And then it was actually Dexter and Link who tried to go in for that final kill. Dexter's the one who stayed in. Link was the one who disengaged, which is why you saw the damage users of CLG staying back and really the sacrificial lambs of CLG going forward, creating the kills and dying.
Still getting the chase on here. And you can actually see how you said the sustained fights kind of want to go to alternate the chase fights for CLG. And as we come out of the replay, Link still chasing around Aranea.
It's more about CLG wants to poke and stay at range a little bit.
Right.
As they kind of poke Kerp down a little bit there, but then they over-engage later, which is why it wasn't a clean fight.
It's not something you see every day.
Can you get him?
No.
Kevin's a little bit too fast.
Still, big damage coming from Nien, actually.
Absolutely. Considering he's also sitting on 2,000 gold. Kevin's sitting on 1,600 as well, so it's actually a fairly fair fight. But as long as they can keep having isolated duels up there, that means Nien is still in the game. We look at the last fight CLG had in their jungle. If they catch the right spears and the right hooks, then yeah, CLG still thinks they have a chance in some of these fights. I just don't know what their answer is for the 5-0 and 4 Lucian on the other side.
We've got a double wave coming in the top lane for Nien right now, but he doesn't have much mana to hang out up top, so I don't think there's going to be too much of an engage. They'll let Kevin clean that up. His teleport is up if they did want to engage, but right now they play it slow. They know there's no pressure or dragon to be worried about. So 25 minutes in, Kreatine 5-0-4 to a 1-2-3 double lift. These guys still have about a 30 CS lead in both of those lanes. Nien has, however, jumped a bit over Kevin, so he's keeping these guys in if they need a tank, if they need someone to be big for him.
The big change is actually in the jungle here. It's a 2,000 gold lead for Aranea over Dexter.
It's true.
European jungler versus European jungler in the Battle of the Atlantic, and the European jungler is out on top. But really, Aranea, just because he's been farming so much, and because his ganks have been the successful ones, he's really just pulling ahead, and it's turning into that combination of Mundo and Shyvana, the optimum dive buddies, just two super tanks that do a whole bunch of damage that everyone over in Europe for that promotion tournament was terrified of teams getting their hands on, and Alternate got it. And we're seeing why people are fearful of
him. Oh, a few shots coming in, the pings as well. We saw that this turret was not safe for them to sit on. Looks like double lift, Aphramu, and Nien get a little bit of help down there too. And do we see, as we look at our mid lane matchup, is it just kind of by chance, or do they have to match each other's power in this? Nobody went Zhonya's, they're all going for kill potential. Or all, both of them, I should say.
Well, it's because both Gragas and Nidalee keep so much distance from each other. That is a very standard build for both of them. Deathcap, two Athenes on Holy Grail, it gives them the mana regen they need, and then the straight up power that they want.
Oh, good dodge. All right. Wow, this is one heck of a dosi. He doesn't get out. Threads the needle. Kreatine finds another culling kill.
He got destroyed when Kreatine hit him with a couple auto attacks, and then the culling was just enough of a tickle to finish him off. CLG was trying to turn that one around, but once they lost a person before they got there, it just became a bad idea.
Oh, I thought they were actually going to go in there on Kerp in middle. You can see four members just saw Kerp in mid, and they didn't go on him.
It's because they don't have enough vision control or map control right now. They're down three turrets entirely.
That's a big thing.
And I believe that's the third dragon in a row that Alternate has controlled. Even Doublelift can't go out farther than that brush.
Still looking at the ward totems, and actually sweepers coming out now. Junglers having one as the supports. CLG may be wanting more to grab back this jungle, but they're actually not working off a lot of wards. Oh, actually, never mind. Alternate just put a ton of wards down.
Yeah, it's real dangerous, though, for CLG to try and sweep things in their own jungle, just because they're not allowed to be there right now. Alternate is the ones who are
It hasn't much really been there since the early game.
And even the time that they're spending sweeping that ward vision down, they're risking getting engaged upon by the rest of them.
Such an effective way to damage. You can see the barrels just continuously hitting Link. Link has to get himself out in the open, so Kurt feels completely free to 1v1 Link, even at the second tier turret in mid, knowing his team's behind him. 9,000, almost 10,000 gold up, and 200, and there's not the 1v1, but the 2v1. Aranea able to find himself in danger. He may not get out of this one. He has to use Dragon's Descent to make his way out. It looks like they will start to back off. CLG should try to pressure something on this.
And we can actually see why CLG's composition was picked. It's not like it was a bad team composition. Just by getting the one stun to Aranea, they almost just popped him down with the spear and the W from Jinx. It's just they have fallen so far behind here. If they get hard engaged on, it's going to be real trouble.
Ooh, let's see what this wave clear looks like. The tower, Jamie gets taken down. There's the grab, but do they want Kevin? Yes, the spear hits. The end gets quite slowed. The Ragnarok is up, but he's holding it. He is holding it for the continuous fight. Will they be able to get in? It's going to be Dexter just with the Q. The percent is not enough to escalate the fight.
And even though CLG is down 9,000 gold, they are threatening Alternate at this turret.
They got the siege wave at the turret, Jet. They should be able to do a good bit of damage. Aranea says no. He wants to get that siege protectant out, but it's going to be double lift. Eyes focused on the turret. 1, 2, 3. He gets excited, and they get out.
That was a really quality push by CLG.
That was dangerous.
They came together as a team and really made that one work. As soon as one person lands a stun or a slow, everyone else can chain in their poke. So if they land an axe or an elite stun, that means that Doublelift and Link get to land their Nidalee Spears and also what they like to call the Zap from Jinx. And it just actually did a substantial amount of damage even to the tankier members of Alternate.
Going back now, looks like Alternate put a few items they did not have under their belts. The Void Staff now for Kurt. That's not being found just yet on the side of Link, but he is 300 gold off, so we'll be very, very close to extreme amount of damage from those spears that you're already getting. Wards still being set up, but a lot have dissipated here, so it's about both teams being able to refine their vision.
Yeah, Doublelift actually just burned his Super Mega Death Rocket there to scout Baron, because CLG was that scared of going and checking it themselves. The thing that would lose CLG the game here is if they got cleanly engaged on 5v5. And that's all that Alternate needs to think about creating right now.
That's exactly what they want to do. That bit of 1 second attack, that spear coming out, and the damage on Aranea. They want to spread that amongst. They will get a good solar flare down. Link is stuck, but he gets the shield and lantern out, keeping himself safe, and they're able to siege protect the second turret. So only losing something they knew they were going to lose. But top lane getting crushed real hard.
Yeah, this is the split game plan for Alternate. Yen needs to be able to take out Kevin, but that's a two-level advantage.
That's Sunfire Cape. Not feeling too well with the Burning Agony. Multiplied on top of her, stacking on top of her, I should say. 10,000 gold is what the gold lead is about to be, and you're seeing that as the turret's pressured down here by Alternate in game one in the Battle of the Atlantic versus CLG. Not much they can do unless they get a perfect engage. It can't be the slightest of sloppiness.
Yeah. I think CLG held that one off pretty well.
They're going to have to.
Substantially some nice shots over the wall by Doublelift, where he was able to get rockets off with the static shiv on Jinx. He just got a decent amount of harass back into Alternate, which made them pull away. And team composition-wise, this is where Alternate kind of needs to make their plays happen. They've taken out the majority of CLG's outer turrets. And the reason that Alternate, you know, I think they should go for Baron right here, but they should de-ward as much as possible in CLG's red jungle. Because we already saw that CLG isn't willing to walk through their jungle if they don't know what's there, and it could mean a high percentage Baron for Alternate if they go for it.
Yeah, they're doing power in numbers right now. Making sure Link is the last one or first one in, last one out. He's the quickest and the safest. Aranea doing what he has all jungle, fearlessly just walking into each brush. He does have a ward there, but still making sure he's the first one to be seen as well. As we come up on 35 minutes, the team's thinking about Baron, but I don't think it's going to be done anytime soon.
And Kevin with the teleport actually means Alternate setting up for something pretty big. Oh! Nope.
It's nice. They've kind of been leading into that a few times. They're drawing that one out. So Jayri was able to catch on to Link last time. They get him that. Kevin looks like he's going to get the turret, though. Nobody's able to give him enough pressure. So he's just going to have this one down to about 25% HP.
CLG shouldn't care about that turret
No.
because they would lose it anyway. But they're sending too many people down for Mundo plus the teleport. unless Dexter were to miracle steal this, it's a absolutely uncontested Baron by ult.
All right, so at this point, as CLG looks at their own minimap, they say, yeah, they're doing Baron. We're all down here.
Yeah.
That's going to be going to alternate. That brings them up to 60,000 gold, and just about a 12,000 gold lead is core items in everybody's pocket on the opposing team.
Alternate knew that that was a high percentage play for them.
Yeah.
Especially when Kevin was able to draw multiple people down from CLG. There was really no appropriate counterplay for CLG once Alternate started that Baron. So it was just smart and well done. It'll mean that Alternate should now shop with the added gold from Baron, and then consider straight up tower diving. As long as the tower gets on Mundo or Shyvana, so Kevin or Aranea, then they can sit on the turret, really, and try and make some damage.
Teleport is one of those spells that just becomes so much stronger as the game goes on. It's like a blitz hook. When you don't use it, you create more with it. If you don't have it, then you're kind of stuck at whatever point you are in the game with running around. So
Teleport kind of is strongest at this point in the game.
Yeah.
And then actually gets weaker as we get a little later, because the teleport's not going to help all
near the
at
base,
all
right.
When they're sieging this really tiny base. It's like, yeah, I can teleport 15 feet next to me, or I can just walk over there and
check
be
this out.
Fine.
Utilizing it perfectly at the moment here. 35 in, 5 turrets to 2, and that first turret was probably one of the biggest things that happened right away in the early part of the game. It meant that already Kerp would be inside the jungle of CLG and Aranea, who was in the jungle. He just had more freedom.
It allowed a lot of access, and we can see that CS lead kind of just expanding into this portion of the game. Aranea very farmed on Shyvana. 198 CS.
Yeah.
199. He's taking the lane minis because he himself is a carry as well. CLG now has to hold off a Baron up alternate. Wow. Kevin still is sitting on that teleport, so it's not the farthest place he could teleport to, but it's still a minor.
He no need minions. He gets the bottom turret down. Nobody's actually going to put any focus down onto him. He's got a wave with him right now, and CLG's looking to actually win this fight and get something off of it, not stop them and just band-aid this situation.
It's tricky, though, because CLG can't really commit to a full-on fight. They have to chip away at alternate. And it's really hard to chip away on a Baron buff team because that Baron buff grants such an immense amount of health regeneration.
Alternate is just making it look quick and easy. Walk perpendicular every time the arrow is thrown. The spear is thrown. See double lift quickly getting the clear out. They have great siege protection on this turret.
They're really good at clearing these waves out. Actually, when there was the cannon minion, Link threw a spear right through the cannon minion and then double lift just killed it with his rockets. CLG's not actually letting the minions get to the turret. Basically, if Alternate wants to find a fight, they're going to have to be willing to completely dive onto the turret, most likely with Dr. Mundo leading the way, which isn't really going to happen if they continue this split-push game.
Looks like Aranea getting a few more blips on his screen. We're going to get that fixed up as they keep sieging.
What do you think of this tattoo right there?
It is, yeah. New tattoos.
Yep, he's got them on both arms.
Triforce.
I saw him over at the European promotional tournament. He likes
it. Yeah, that's why you get
so.
It.
Yeah. Anyway, we got this pause. And it's actually been held off for a pretty long time by CLG, but they're by no means in control. They are completely on the back foot. It's just taken a little while for Alternate to continue pushing them over.
It comes down to it. Once you get to that base, I always like to say it's like you get a bit of extra gold. The lane narrows, you got some walls to work with. You don't really get any gold or stats, but you have a better chance of defending something, and everybody, your character abilities may be a bit more effective. Like, Doublelift can shoot rockets over the wall. Mm-hmm. They can throw undertows over the wall. So they are trying to use that. Like you said, they're getting the minion waves cleared, and it helps to an extent. It obviously isn't one person farming. Everybody's sharing partially the gold that comes in, so everything comes real slow from this point, but
yeah.
It's still quite early considering the games we've seen. We could have 20 more minutes, and that means CLG is going to be pretty big because everybody's almost 5 items right now.
Yeah, and RNA just has a really quick client restart. So we can actually kind of recap maybe how we got here in the first place. There was definitely a very weak laning phase from CLG. At the very start of the game...
Has to be noted.
At the very start of the game, Aframu got killed very early on by the Mundo. And then after that, they just couldn't get control of their jungle, as you were saying.
Right.
RNA counter-jungled the crap out of him. COG could not get any dragon control. And it's been this slow bleed ever since with Alternate trying to finish off CLG.
To CLG's efforts, they did do a good counter gank in the bottom, but it kind of fell apart from there. That one kill did not follow up. Seems like the filtering of information was just done better. Arnan knew he was going to counter jungle this whole game, and he has made it real tough for Dexter. Good damage on the back line. They are going super deep. Like, the turret isn't even there. Damage to the turret doesn't even happen. I guess it's not there.
Teleport trying to come in. Maybe they're going to try and tank up the turret because COD's pretty low right now.
This has been a bit of an extended engage. They're going to telegraph it, but they still get what they want, and they can engage after the turret. The culling keeps everybody spread out to the right side, and you can see Doublelift trying to use that tree to get some shots off and hide behind it, but there is so much poke that can come back at them. They really have a great way to defend this.
As soon as Alternate decided to use Mundo as a giant minion to tank the turret for him, they were able to just push right through CLG. It gave Kerb time specifically to land enough harass and get CLG off of defense mode.
Oh, Kreatan going big, gets the Banshee's Veil out, 6-0-4. Actually has been beaten CS by Doublelift, but only because that's why they're feeding it into lane. That's a pretty ambitious flash. We'll see if they can catch him. They have stacking slow here.
He's gonna flash over
the
wall.
They can get on. There's the clutch down. Nien's on the other side of the wall. Oh, nobody saw that, but he is gonna go down. 12-7 now on the score. A little bit of gold is brought back, but the lanes are hurting right now. And the top wave is going to be big, so see what CLG can do with this.
If you're ever going to chase a Mundo with five people, that's actually the time to do it.
Yeah.
There was no threats elsewhere on the map where Alternate could take advantages, and they not only get the kill, looks like they get the turret too, Rib. That was a smart play by CLG to chase down Kevin.
Take one thing, you got to take the next. They also got his flash down. Mundo alt comes up pretty quickly, so he'll still be effective in the next fight, but he will have to run his way home. Kerb's going to farm out the top lane, so it doesn't look like Alternate's going to be forcing any... or too many fights, I should say. You still have Shyvana and Leona in the mid lane. Who knows? But right now, they'll keep it lax and push the lanes.
We might see Alternate just waiting for the next Baron. Especially since when they're sieging,
that
they take
confident.
So much little bit of poke.
That's true.
Right? And I don't think it's because they're not confident in themselves. I think it's just a smart move.
See what these supports have for themselves. Aphromoo is still trying to get himself tanky, and Athene's to a giant spell on the Ruby Crystal, Locket, and the Talisman of Ascension, which doesn't, as we talked about, give the stats out for the HP and whatnot, but that's still a big J-Ree.
Yeah, that's another tank for them, really. Especially when he has that W on from Leona, his stats just explode through the roof. It gives him 75 armor and 73 magic resist when he's got his W on.
That's just
a little
bit.
With his thousands and thousands of health. One thing to note, though, is if Doublelift can miraculously stay safe, he does more damage than Kreatan right now because he hasn't built a defensive item, aside from that Negatron clip, which he just completed recently. And he's just got more damage multipliers going on right now.
50 seconds on both Baron and Dragon. Alternate is trying to keep them pushed. Oh, it's going to be the Zhonya's.
He
finally puts it in his belt. He will go down. Nien puts himself in the fight. Nien is the only one in there right now. Link and Doublelift trying to throw from the outside. Dexter is not able to do much in this fight, and Link makes it out. The double buff is on him, Nien rather, and we're going to see if they will re-engage. They don't like not having Kerb.
The spear goes through and hits Kerb. It's a whole lot of trouble, as we saw there. So COG still packing a punch. This one's not going to be over too easily for Alden. It's a pretty long death timer, too. We have 40 seconds, which means COG might try to push out of mid lane. He's actually going to be dead when Baron respawns. Maybe we could even see a fight of Baron here, 5v4 for COG. This could slingshot them back in the game.
Got to take out that first siege minion wave. They want to make sure. This is difficult to go. RNA is very low. Being that low means this is more of an engage. They're going very strong on this. Smites are up on both junglers.
It's very dangerous as a poke comp to go into Baron against two people who want sustained fights, Kevin and Aranea. Let's see how COG handles this one. They're all running out of the pit, but Link's getting beasted down.
All right, they are able to jump it out. Very nice job with the lanterns, but how much have they given? They're going to have to walk all the way around. I'll just say, Aranea, that would be a very risky call.
But the 5v4 only has a couple of seconds left, and Baron is still at half health. COG wants to stay in this one, but they're going to be trapped in a 5v5 for a bit longer if they do.
Here comes Kerb. He's just on the outside. They may go hard on this. Oh, my God. Shots coming in from Doublelift.
Really?
Junglers are inside. The spike goes down. RNA is able to grab Nashor. And it looks like Alternate will make their way to the base. They will clear down the mid wave. They don't have a bottom to push, but they do have a top.
That was actually a genius plan by COG, but it was poorly executed. Dexter, even though he can spike the Baron down, with his Venomous Bite at the same time of smiting and do more damage than Aranea, Aranea is the one who smited it out. So the health bar management from Dexter was off there, and it actually just gives Alternate their second Baron of the game.
The 50-50 heads up Baron, so intense and actually brought out. Both junglers had a chance. And we see Alternate coming out on top. Now a 15,000 gold lead. Dragon will be fought over for a little bit, but that gold's going to be very much so needed by CLG right now.
Yeah, that gives almost as much gold as Baron at this point. Baron
gives 1,500. Teams fighting that.
Dragon gives 1,300. Dragon's a little easier to kill.
Yeah.
For one. But now it's the Baron regen once again, which is what ended up cascading down that middle inhibitor turret. Of course, the middle inhibitor is back up. I think Alternate's going to be able to take that one. It's definitely what they're planning next.
Looking at Kevin's to Nian's build, when you know someone is building full outright tank, you don't have to follow that at all. They'll still be able to take him out as this late game comes.
They're definitely going to try to. I mean, Olaf and Mundo can do slightly different build paths, and they've been able to kill them slowly, but now with the Baron buff, I don't know if they can.
It looks like he is going to be absolutely unstoppable. Thornmail, Sunfire, Spirit Visions, and the Randuins to keep it going. They are getting the good pulse down, Jack. This is how you said it has to happen. Aphramu gets engaged on. It's going to be Lucian. Creatine to the back line. Gets one shot in. Will he get the second kill on Nian? The Culling just following on the backside. But look at Kevin. Can't be stopped in that 2v1. Pulls himself out now. Doublelift trying his damnedest to shoot the brick wall. But nothing is chipping off. The inhibitor is low. And they've taken out members as well. The HP bar is going down. But the inhibitor is going to fall first.
The damage dealers are still up for CLG, but they have to flash away. What happened in that fight, Riv, is they thought they could catch on to the squishy guy, but no one could get through the meat by the end of it because Aphramu went in, no one could get past the tank line, and it ended up being a clean fight for all of it. They're going to look to sweep these turrets down.
Looking very, very low here. Link knows he can't dive in. They know they cannot aggress on this. The poke is all that they have. They got Kevin locked up. His ultimate's just about to come up as well. Flame Chomper's on the ground. Dexter with a huge chunk of damage coming out. Link saves his life. Shut down. Doublelift gets excited. Do they have the speed? Link flashes over but doesn't want to be there. Goes down by the hands of Kerb.
Just imagine if CLG had actually gotten that last Baron. All these people that are regened up wouldn't be. CLG trying desperately to fight off Alternate.
All of these health bars were just as low as the last inhibitor we saw on the side of Alternate. But now at full health, near full health, they back off, walking away with their heads held high and a base to be taken on the side of CLG.
Yeah, and let's just actually see right here. Creatine got a little overzealous with that. Doublelift's last auto attack was able to finish him off. But then Link got a bit ahead of himself. Not only did he get hit by the Cleaver, he got hit by the Gragas as well. Here is nowhere for him to run.
One last drink before you go down.
May as well.
45 minutes into this, we said it may be going the length, but the laning phase did not go anything as we would see. And the late game is being pushed back on CLG more than most would have thought as well. Alternate playing very well, almost fully itemed up here. And RNA is now going for a Blade of the Rune King, just putting the Cutlass in his inventory.
But COG's getting there as well.
Yes.
That's the dangerous
thing. This is the holdoff we were talking about. At 35, we said, give him 20.
14,000 gold is much more than they want to deal with. But Doublelift is sitting at pretty much 6 items. Also, Link is 1 item away. So he's sitting at 5. He's right competitive with what Kerp is doing. We saw one spear from Link could nearly clean out Kerp. I think if Nian could finish off his item build, Nian's really far away from his item build. Those last 3 items aren't finished full items for him. He needs to upgrade all of those, and then CLG might be able to repel them. Looking at that last engagement, though, when Alternate all had Baron, and it was kind of a 3v5, and CLG was still able to repel them,
yeah,
there's hope yet.
I feel like CLG's comp is actually coming a bit more into what they wanted, seeing the Crucible come out, now the Mercurial Scimitar, as well as having that cleanse as well on Doublelift. They always get themselves out of a chaotic fight, but there's nothing chaotic crowd control to happen. All the bursts just happen from Alternate, so.
Another Leona ult down without
this
landing.
One in. There's in Creatine, good damage onto the AD carry that forces him backwards. The Talisman of Ascension goes off. ZLG is starting to get a little bit bigger here in these fights.
And that was the worst push Alternate has had yet.
Yeah.
They got almost no turret, and if Creatine would have went down, it could have cascaded into many more kills once Doublelift's Jinx got excited. There's a lot of danger coming from Alternate now. They're kind of... One good play from Alternate could win them the game because they're pushed so far into CLG. But COG probably needs a series of good plays in order to come back. But with how close that last one is, the next play could really go either way.
This is really going to tell it, Jat. The teleport being up for them last time messed up that communication. It hurt where they were positioned, but it looks like they will not just send Kevin down to the bottom lane. They'll decide to back here. They have something to get before their last hurrah.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if the last hurrah is going to be that soon.
Probably not.
Definitely, a minute 15 seconds from now, Baron's going to respawn. I wonder if CLG tries to fight there again. It's a dangerous proposition because they're holding quite well, but if they just give up to Baron, it does seem like Alternate would be able to push through for inhibitor number two.
Well, that was like one of the most forced Barons we've really ever seen here. Nobody has used Baron that way to fight each other while both taking it down to about 1,000 health before they decided to. Usually it's one or the other, the fight happens, and then they take Baron. So these teams are putting everything on the line when it needs to be.
And if someone were to get picked off here for Alternate, CLG would be able to get the Baron. If I was Alternate, I wouldn't be in this situation right now. I would just pull back, use this time to control the jungle near the Baron and work on securing that, but Alternate has other ideas.
This part of the game usually tends to slow down quite a bit. It's like the team can't get past that door anymore. Right now, they're looking for that inhibitor. Has come back up in mid. No engagement there, but we're looking at Jayree. There's the solar flare going on the backside. The burnout goes down, and it's all just the flex of muscles they needed for the inhibitor.
Kerb's ultimate hit so hard right now, it immediately sends CLG back. And yes, to their credit, they were able to get the inhibitor there. Now they can pull back for Baron.
Slowing themselves down, CLG.
Oh, they're waiting for something.
CLG doesn't really have the ward right there. Swept out. Only one more vision sits out the outside of Baron.
They're behind him.
Here it comes. It's Alternate coming in from the backside. It's going to be the Dragon Descent right into the box. How much damage can this provide for them, though? Both teams are actually backing off of this. They wanted CLG to engage on that, but CLG wanted to feel out the fight.
Who can poke who harder right now? Kerp is waiting for his Gragas ult to be back up. CLG is trying to chase through, and they're actually taking more poke than Alternate is.
Alternate taking the long way around inside the base of CLG. They're going to take an inhibitor, possibly this inhibitor. They're going to take the turret, rather. We'll see Jayree doing what he can as the melee up front. And that's got to be considered. These guys are melee taking out structures.
That's
one shot there. It's going to be Leona going down. Jayree finds it. Can RNA be the next one to go down? The zap does not hit Kerp. The Ragnarok is not on. The Ghost is, though. There's the Undertow on. It's going to be Link into the brush. Link finds Kerp. It's going to be the Zhonya's and the safety for the rest of the team.
That's two kills right there for CLG, but they're down two inhibitors. They're in a tough place right now because they want to go for Baron, but their base is in peril.
They have great, great pushes on the top and the bottom lane. It could not be better with having zero people pushing those lanes at any given time in the past 20 minutes. Baron's going in their favor right now. It looks like they have a good enough sort or caster minion wave to grab bottom lane, and Baron will be theirs at 50 minutes to teleport. That has to be stopped.
Oh, he came
in! It's Kreatin on the back line! Kreatin going in hard! He throws down, another Banshee's Veil gets popped off of him. And looks like, oh, he gets not dead. So sliver of health as he limps away. Arnea goes in by himself, gets taken down, and CLG just turns this game around.
And you can see double of snipe off Alternate with his Super Mega Death Rocket. They actually have three dead right now, and they might try to brute force down some Alternate turrets here.
They got a lot of turrets to deal with here, chat. They only have one big tank that counts in this game, and it looks like they are going to head towards the bottom lane. They do have a huge mini wave to work with, and this is going to be a 51-minute stretch if they can do it.
They're just going to keep pushing on. This time, they have the Baron, and they're still a lot dead for Alternate Riv.
The inhibitor goes down. 44 seconds on Lucian and Shyvana. They do have Kerp back up.
They want to end it right
Huge
here if they can.
Damage. Kerp has the ultimate up. He will be able to blast them off. Link, the solar flare hits three and slows. You're going to see Link going down instantly, completely obliterated from the fight. CLG stands with four, and they all can deal damage, but I don't know if they have what it takes.
They just keep this fight going. They get the hook.
The hook onto him. Kerp goes for the Zhonya's. The box sits around him, and it's going to put him under. They go for kills back and forth as the Retribution comes up.
double lift. Can he finish it? The Rocket takes down Jay Reid. Kevin is doing what he can to live. His ultimate comes up in about 25 seconds, and there's not enough minutes to win the game.
There's no dealing with Muna right now, but this game is completely flipped around. Actually, if Ultimate can stop Double Lift from backing, the minions could kill CLG's base.
They have to get back in time. CLG knows the power of minions when it comes to the endgame fight. They are trying to make their way through.
Don't kill
they
the dragon.
They know they can't
base.
Back there. Trying to walk, trying to the auto attack. They should be able to get back without... Oh, wow. I
that's
was going to say
down.
Without too much damage,
oh,
but
can Muno
that's damage.
Him? Nope, Double Lift is back. He's back in base.
Still trying to run. Oh, whoa.
Oh.
So close. So close. And it looks like the turret may not be safe. Oh, my gosh. The turret getting it so hard.
It's down.
No
it's
way.
Down.
That
it finished off.
Is not the easiest thing to save. You have a teleport on Moondaw now. Kevin and RNA are coming into the base. These guys are full throttle.
And Double Lift is still trapped in base. This game just got absolutely out of control right now. But I think everyone's respawned. COG has nothing left in their base. I'd say it's game on.
People are scratching, even the players are scratching their heads right now. You can see a bit of communication, their size. I don't even know if they can buy anything else. We got a Frozen Heart coming in on Nien, as well as his War Mogs. These guys are stacked.
Let's take a little bit of a step back here for a second.
Sounds good.
Alternate got a little bit overzealous in COG's base, and that's how all of this madness started. And it kind of needs to be a lesson here that when death timers are 75 seconds long and Double Lift is at like the absolute maximum six items,
only 23,000 gold.
You gotta be a little bit careful. He's only got 518 CS. There's plenty to go from here. It's actually max items. He's totally full. But really, this game, even though there is no defense at COG's base, there is almost no defense at Alternate's base either. I can't say COG will come back from this one because they have lost everything around their Nexus, and Alternate has got to play this next thing more safely. I feel like they overgreeted on that top turret.
That fight was based on them thinking they just had it too much. They could do too much with what they had at the time.
Especially the fight afterwards at Baron. When they went in one after the other, Mundo and then Aranea. Sure, it was impressive because they're really tanky and they think they can just teleport into five people, but that's just sloppy play and it nearly cost Alternate this game. They still have a chance to finish it off, though.
Well, first battle of the Atlantic Day. Definitely pleasing. 54 minutes into this one, almost hitting an hour. And it's 95,000 to 84. Oh, Aranea threading the needle behind some minions. Very nicely played there. Uses the flash to get out. He still has the Dragon's Descent to come up, so he shouldn't be in too bad of a spot if they need to initiate.
Well, the thing with COG as well is all three of their inhibitors have actually respawned. So even though their Nexus is unprotected, unless someone kills an inhibitor and then moves on, they've got a bit of a buffer before someone could really backdoor their entire base. Double if that's a dangerous way to go. He's fine. But he should not have ran that way. Wow,
so we got
one of those AoE hits is hitting for 1,000 on the minions from Double Lift. That can hit a team, so pretty scary.
A very, very big team if you look at it. Leona and actually Afro move for himself, both picking up Warmogs, moving up to the 80 carries. It was a 6-0 and 5 Creatine versus Double Lift, who wasn't doing very well. Now 8-2 and 6.
We did say Double Lift's Jinx would outscale Creatine Lucian, and that has definitely happened. I think these fights are going to hinge on whether or not a squishy can get caught by something. And I'm only going to count four squishies in this game. It's Link and Double Lift on CLG and Kerp and Creatine on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
If any of them land their poke on a squishy, it's over. But if the tanks can just move through, Alternate's tank line is also much stronger than CLG's. So if Kevin and Aranea can block all the stuff while Alternate is able to do damage, Alternate's going to win this fight. CLG kind of has to get lucky in these fights in order to win them, I think.
And we have to consider, Alternate probably should have won this game by now. So they faltered.
Ago.
Yeah, they faltered moving up to the base. And that just seems to happen here as they may try to engage onto a fight. But still, It's coming down to, it's not that they don't want to win, it's that these teams don't want to lose.
Exactly. And they're trying the side swipe initiations on each other now.
Yeah.
I think this Pokefest in the middle lane does favor alternate right now. We know they're stronger in straight up fights, and they're just going right for the exposed inhibitor. This is forcing CLG to fight here.
They saw the teleport to the left actually on the way in, so they can
Mundo
really
can
approach
get
this.
Him. Greg, oh my god!
That's what? Game!
What was that? He just won the game with a couple buttons, and the Nexus is undefended.
That was spiked. I don't think that was legal. They're looking for the Nexus, the Battle of the Atlantic. A game that I think turned everyone on their heads. The first of the series goes to Alternate.
And wow. It's a little shocking that it ended like that. Kerp, the bootless Gragas, barrel from heaven, just destroyed Blink and Dexter. Holy crap.
I don't,
Yep, that's that. You fight back for 57 minutes.
Wow.
You turtle your base. You hold after losing both your Nexus turrets. And then Kerb hits a couple buttons. Welcome to mid lane.
I don't think I've ever seen that happen. That was
that was interesting.
Fast.
That was really fast. That's a good way of putting it. There was just the Athene's Unholy Grail defensively for Link. And both those barrels hit him at the same time. That'll do it. We can talk about the whole game.
We could.
That's what ended it.
Yeah.
Boop.
So we were bringing it up right before they did actually win it. They probably heard me say it, that they should have won that game a good 20 minutes ago.
They could have controlled their tower diving a little better if Kevin and Aranea went harder while they had the Baron buffs at tanking the turrets and prioritizing the turret damage a bit. I definitely think Alternate could have won more cleanly. But seeing as how they kind of falter near the end, and CLG showed a lot of quality team play down the stretch, I think CLG's got a lot more coming for game two.
Also got to give a thumbs up to Alternate for having only Lucian as a ranged and still being able to dive / take down turrets the way they did with all those melees.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's why they were struggling a little bit, is because Lucian himself isn't the longest range AD carry, and it's a little bit risky.
Yeah.
But because they had so much beef in the front of their team,
That's what I was thinking. I'm like, this Mundo's getting really big. I don't know if you're going to be able to do that. So we may see a Mundo ban just in general because even with the Olaf getting tanky, they still couldn't produce that amount of brick wall for a defense.
Yeah. It was a pretty difficult hold for CLG. But the weird thing is they kind of dealt with the tanks. They lost all control of the game, but when they look back at this game, they'll think, wow, if we just didn't get outmaneuvered late in the game, we'd still be turtling.
That's right true. Now. They actually had a way to pull that back. They were getting so much stronger.
A lot
stronger.
Of that turn for Alternate really just